Are you on Team Kalle or Team Mélilot? Are you just venturing into shirt making and wondering which shirt to start with? Sharing some of the similarities and differences of both shirts today to help you make a decision. Hi, my name's Sam. Welcome to my channel, Frugalissima, where I talk about all things sewing, particularly dressmaking. Today I've got a deep dive into the Kalle shirt, which is this one here, and the Mélilot shirt, and a bit of a blend of both, which is the one that I'm wearing here. But first of all, I'd just like to say thank you to everyone who's subscribed so far. I'm nearing the magical 1,000 subscribers, which would enable me to be able to set up a community page on YouTube, and we can have little polls on there and decide on what videos I make in the future, which I've been aiming to do since I've started with the 100 Days of Sewing. And the 100 Days of Sewing is just a series of videos that I've been putting together. Whether you're new to sewing or you want to sew on a budget like I do, some hints and tips, some tutorials and some sew-alongs on there. So on to today's video. I've long been a fan of the Kalle shirt from Closet Core Patterns and have made three in the past. In February I picked up the Mélilot shirt pattern, which is this one here, in the printed version when I went to the Manchester Sewing Bee. I think somebody had it on. I'll give it a go. And I think on the surface, they're both very similar. They're both woven shirts, you know, they've both got that deep hem on them. But there are some significant differences. So I thought I'd go into that for you. And maybe if you're thinking of buying one or the other pattern, it might help you make a decision. Or like me, buy both and blend them together. So I'm going to start with the Kalle. That's the one I've got most experience with, and that's this one modelled by my able assistant Mandy the mannequin. Just go into some of the features of each design, and then I'll sort of talk about the differences and the similarities. So there are three length options with a Kalle shirt. You've got the cropped length, the tunic length, and the dress length. This is the dress length. You can't actually see it, but I will put some footage of me wearing it. Then you've got three placket options with the Kalle. This is the popover option. Then you've got the full hidden placket, and then you've got the just like the regular placket, which is what we've got here. You can call it a visible placket if you like, but it's not hidden. You can see the buttonholes from the top. It's a dropped shoulder. You've got a cuffed sleeve hem at the back. On the Kalle, you've got a yoke option, and then this pleat here, you've got the option to either invert it like it is here or to be a boxed option. So the Kalle also uses the burrito method for attaching the yoke to the front and the back, and that's nothing to be scared of at all. It does explain it really, really well on how to do it. But once you've done one and you've got your head around it, it is quite a straightforward technique. I think the interesting features on the Kalle are the three different lengths. They are quite significantly different. I'll show you what I mean by that. This is the cropped version. Again, you've got the popover placket there, and you've got the deep curve here, very high low. And you can see how it goes in at the side there, and I think what's significant about it is this facing method at the hem. I think that's what's the point of difference on the Kalle, is that curved hem and how it's finished. So that's the front hem facing and what it looks like. So obviously you're going to be using a little bit more fabric with that. The tunic length and the dress length are actually just bias bound. So obviously you've got to think about that when you're choosing fabric. But I did get that cropped version out of a remnant, and I think it was only about a metre. And it does give you the opportunity to use contrast fabric there. So you could use contrast fabric there, you know, just to make it look a bit different. The most significant difference between the Kalle and the Mélilot really is that the Mélilot it's more fitted. All the versions of the Mélilot have a bust out, and it comes in at the waist. whereas the Kalle is straight up and down, and the shaping comes from that inverted pleat that I've just showed you. That's the most significant difference. I think once you sew them up, you'll notice that the instructions are different as well, both in clarity and technique. Both patterns will start you with the button plackets, but with the Mélilot then you go straight onto the bust dart and then do the hem. Normally with most patterns you do the hem last, but with the Mélilot you do the hem and then you French seam it, and these French seams are automatically written into the pattern, which I think that's a good thing. I mean, you've got the option to do French seams with any pattern that you make, or most patterns that you make, but it automatically tells you to do French seams, which I like. The only thing is, the way that they do it is they start with a quarter of an inch, and then you don't trim it down, and you sew 3/8 of an inch. That is the easier way, in that you're not having to trim it in between. But I think it gives you a bulkier seam. You're not setting in that seam, so you've got that deep curve here. You don't want too much bulk, really. So I did it the other way around. I sewed at 3/8 of an inch, trimmed it down, and then my second seam was 1/4 of an inch. It's just that's personal preference. The design of the Kalle is largely loose fitting. It's supposed to skim your body. It's not supposed to be voluminous, but it is supposed to sort of skim your body. But it doesn't come in at the waist here. Now, they have just updated this pattern, and I have printed off the new pattern and used the new pattern pieces. They've updated the sizing range, and they've made some tweaks to prevent the dress from pulling to the back when it's being worn. So they've shifted the shoulder seams and reduced some of the volume in the pleat at the back. With the Kalle, you've got the popover placket, you've got the hidden button placket, you've got the normal placket, you've got two colour options, you've got the pointed collar. This is a collar piece, and there is actually a separate piece for the upper collar and the under collar on the Kalle, and you can see it's quite pointed, whereas the Mélilot has got quite a, I've just left the sizes on there so you know that, but it's got quite more of a Peter Pan type collar on it, so you can see they're quite significantly different there. Both of them have got the Mandarin collar option. But the Kalle doesn't have the sleeve option, so both of them have got this cuffed sleeve option. But the Mélilot has a sleeved option, but the Kalle is available, but at an additional cost. If you bought the sleeve option from the Kalle, that comes with a French cuff or a double cuff. So rather than it being this deep, it would be sort of quite deep up your arm. So on to the sizing. Like I said, they've just updated the sizing range for the Kalle. So the Kalle goes from a 0 to 30. The updated range is from the size 14 to 30. That translates from a 31-inch bust up to a 56-inch bust. So quite a large size range there. The Mélilot is a bit more limited in that it only goes from a 31.5 inch bust up to a 45.5 inch bust. So fabric choices are pretty similar. I've used these are lawns and shirting cottons. You can use a viscose, or I think this silk is one of the options as well. So the fabrics recommendations on the Mélilot: batiste, cotton, satin, viscose, silk and flannel. And obviously whatever your fabric choice is going to make a significant difference to how the garment sits and hangs on you. Fabric options for the Kalle are linen, tencel, rayon, a silk crepe de chine, or a pop. If obviously if you're using a poplin or a chambray or a flannel or anything like that, then that will give you a stiffer sort of look. So the options that I've used have all been cotton, the exception of my first Mélilot, which was made in a viscose. That's this one here. And you can see how it drapes more at the sleeve. In terms of instructions, I would say that the instructions for the Kalle are much, much clearer. I've used Closet Core Patterns a few times, so I am used to how she writes her instructions. I would say that they're much clearer and that they're written for the beginner seamstress in mind. I think the instructions for Deer and Doe bearing in mind that they will have been written in French originally and then translated, the clear, but the brief. I think that's probably the best description. So, for example, the instructions, I've just actually been on the Fold Line Facebook group and somebody has just said, how do I do this hidden button placket? Because she couldn't work it out from the instructions. And I'm just going to show you what it says to do. So you've got, this is for the hidden button placket, these two instructions here. And then these two instructions for both versions, for the normal. That's it. If it's your first shirt, I don't think the Mélilot is probably the best option. Go for it if you fancy it, but I just think they're a little bit vague. So effectively what you want to end up with the Mélilot is some sort of concertina. This is your furthest line away from the edge, which you fold to the back. You then sew down this second line here, then press it all to the front and concertina it in, so that where the buttons should be underneath here, the button hole band should be underneath here. What it doesn't tell you to do is to tuck this bit under, which is obviously your edge, and that wants to be tucked under when you sew it all down at the back. So you're left with a flap, effectively. It's concertinaed like that. The instructions aren't great on the cuffs either. So if you want me to do any further explanations of how to construct the placket or how to construct the sleeves, then let me know and I will put something together if you're struggling. It does take some head scratching, but I think sometimes if you go back to your pattern, rather than trying to do it with a fabric, go back to your pattern pieces and try and work it out on the pattern rather than trying to do it on your fabric and having to unpick. Sometimes you can just get your head around things that way. That's what I do anyway. So the first Mélilot that I made was the short sleeve version, and I just made that out of a remnant just to make sure that it fitted. So you've got your cuff there. This is just a really lightweight viscose, so it's just I just love the blue in it. I have talked about this one before. So you can see there's no yoke at the back there. Your shoulders go straight into your beginning of your sleeves, and I just wanted to make sure that it fitted, and I've lengthened this by 2 inches because it's like it's drafted for somebody who's 5'6" and I'm 5'8". And then I went into the second Mélilot, which I put the collar on both of them, but this has just got the hidden placket here, which I like. I like the effect of that. And the sleeves, and I've talked about the sleeves before. There's no finished sleeve length that I could find on the pattern, either on the instructions or on the website, and they were too short, by about two inches. So I've added 2 inches to the sleeve length. You can see there, they're just perfect sleeve length. So the price of the Mélilot is €14 for the paper version, which comes out at £12.89, and €11 for the PDF, which comes out at £10. $20 for the paper version of the Kalle, which works out at £15, and the PDF is $16, which works out at £12.58. That's depending on on what day it is. Both of them, I would say, are intermediate level. Miss Mélilot, it's telling you it's level 4 out of 5. So yeah, I would say it's an intermediate level. And I definitely wouldn't want to be making the Mélilot as my first shirt. So in terms of sizes, I made a size 42 for the Mélilot, for a bust of 37¾, a waist of 30 inches, and a hip of 40¼ inches. So you've got a little bit of wear and ease on this. I'm a 37 inch bust, I'm actually 33 inch waist now, and my hips are usually about 41, but it skims past your waist. Although it comes in at the waist, it skims past the waist. It's more important to get the shoulders and the bust fitting, and you can come out at the waist, but obviously with a French seam that's a little bit more difficult. I made a size 10 in the Kalle, and I will put the sizes down at the bottom because I've not got those to hand. So all three of the Kallis that I've made in the past have all had the mandarin collar and the popover placket. I've never done the full length placket on all three of them. Done all three lengths, and I've not done the full collar either. I've done the mandarin collar, and obviously there's no option without buying the sleeve expansion pack. So they've all got the short sleeve and cuffs. So I wanted something a little bit more winter appropriate or autumn appropriate, really. So I thought, I wonder if I can put the sleeves of the Mélilot onto the Kallis. And that's what I've done here. So these are the sleeves from the Mélilot, and because they're both drop shoulders, I just laid one pattern over the top of the other, the Mélilot and the Kallis, just to see if the arm size was going to be the same. And they were very, very similar, so I just graded it in ever so slightly, because obviously it's quite difficult to do because you've got the yoke on here that you've got to take account into account on the Kallis. And there's no yoke on the Mélilot, so you've got to take that into account when you're making that decision. Yeah, I blended them both together. I went for the full button down placket. I didn't have enough fabric for the hidden placket. I have to add in 2 inches to both the Mélilot and the Kallis because I'm 5'8", so I've actually added in 2 inches. And I will show you some footage of me wearing this one. And it is relatively short. It might be too short for some people's comfort zone. I'm more than happy to wear this in the summer with a pair of trainers, sneakers, whatever you want to call them, and nothing on my legs. But it shouts summer, does this top. The tunic length I just wear with jeggings or whatever and boots. And this one I will wear with thick tights and boots. And probably belt it. The other significant difference that I made is I brought the Kallis in like the Mélilot comes in. So rather than it being straight down, I just brought it in at the waist, and I just again laid over the Mélilot pattern over my Kallis, and just brought that in. I just wanted a little bit more shape into it. And then with the collar, I use the Kallis collar. And then I just got a cotton reel and curved that off. So I didn't want the drama of the Mélilot. I just wanted just to round it off. And that's because these cuffs are quite rounded. So I just wanted to take the sharpness off the edge of that. So I've just ended up with it ever so slightly rounded there. So not quite so sharp. And that suits my preferences. And then, as you can see here, I've used a contrast. This is a lightweight linen on the under collar here, understand here. I've also used it on the back of the yoke and the inside of the cuffs. I thought this blue matched perfectly with the blue that goes through it, and I thought it would also blend in with the work from home module that I've been working on as well. So I'll show some footage of me wearing this as I would wear it with a belt and boots, with the cardigan over the top of it that I've made for the work from home module, because I'd always intended this to be part of that module. So I find that the instructions for the Kallis are much more straightforward for the insertion of the collar. So if you've never inserted a collar before, I would say that the instructions for that are quite clear. I'm afraid I can't say that for the Mélilot, and the cuffs just had me confounded. And I think it's because they are just so brief. They're not sort of explaining to you what should be underneath and what should be on top. And I think that's just a couple of words that would make a difference. You've really got to think it through before you start sewing. They're not the easiest of instructions, I don't think. And the collar's a bit similar. So when I went into making this one, I only bought 2 metres of fabric. So I wanted to use as much of it as I possibly could, in that I didn't want a random half a metre left. But I needed also to make sure that I had enough to do the cuffs in case the sleeve didn't work out. So I went for the full length. But I didn't have enough to do the hidden button placket, and I used the technique in the Mélilot to do the hem. I did the double hem rather than using the bias binding that's in the Kalle. Hemmed it, and then sewed the side seams together as French seams, as you do in the Mélilot. So I'm really pleased with it. I'll show you some footage of me wearing it as a dress, and as I'm wearing it as an overshirt today because it's a bit chilly in here. So I've got an Edie top on underneath it. And I think it works both ways. It works really nice as a casual overshirt, and I'll wear this to work, probably belted with a pair of boots and tights and what have you. Tights and boots, everybody says that, don't they? So this cropped length is the one that I've found the hardest to style, really. It is very, very cropped. I've seen a few people lengthen this part down to the same length as that, which is an option. I did make this as a toile out of a remnant, just to make sure it fitted. So I was very limited on how much fabric that I could use. I've put a pocket on this one, and I've used these metal snap fasteners for it. These have been the bane of my life. They just fall off. The plastic snap, the cam snaps work okay, but I didn't want the plastic ones on here. I liked these pearlized ones because I thought it went with a little, it's like a constellation design on here. And this is just a shirt in cotton. And then I've just done normal buttons on both the other ones. So I wanted to experiment a little bit with this one, in that I've never put the full collar on. I've only ever done the popover placket, and I wanted to try it with the full sleeves and make it more seasonally appropriate. The significant differences between the Mélilot and the Kalle are that the Kalle is a more relaxed fit, whereas the Mélilot is slightly more fitted. It's not fitted in that, you know, it's not super fitted, so you've got a little bit of wiggle room in there. The Kalle is designed to skim the body, and the Mélilot just comes in at the waist, and you've got your bust darts. The updated version of the Kalle from sizes 14 to 30, I think it is, have got bust darts in it as well, and that has been drafted for a D cup. So yeah, your Kalle's got more options in there. It's got the three lengths, the three button plackets. You've got your inverted and new box pleat option. If you did all the different ones, you probably have something like the opportunity to make 24 different garments with the Kalle. The only drawback, I think, is that the sleeve isn't included, that you've got to pay the extra $6 for a sleeve, which isn't much, but it's a more expensive pattern in the first place to buy. The similarities are they're both shirts, both woven shirts, both got the collar option, they both got the full placket option, and it's the deep curved hem that makes them so similar. And the fact that when you look at this option with a cuffed short sleeve and that curved hem there, I think they look very similar on the surface. So do you need both? Well, it depends on what you're looking for. I think really the Mélilot is closer to a shirt, whereas the Kalle is closer to a tunic in style. If you're trying to decide which one to buy, that would depend entirely on how fitted you wanted it, really. I would say go for the Mélilot if you've got a bit of experience and you're happy with brief instructions, and that you don't want 24 options, because not everybody does. You've got more printing to do. I think there's only 20 odd pages for printing out the Mélilot. I bought the printed version, so I didn't have to print it out. If you want lots of options with you want more bang for your buck, then the Kalle is the one for you. Less structured, more floating feel, and you've got lots of options with it. I mean, I've seen lots of people sort of use this button, if the full button band, the outside of this cuff and the mandarin collar in one colour, and the rest of it in another colour. So you've got colour blocking options there. And I've also seen the options with playing with stripes on the yoke at the back. And obviously with the Mélilot, you don't have a yoke at the back, so you wouldn't be able to do that. And also you've got the option of, with the cropped version, of playing about with the colour of this facing as well. I think if I were to make this cropped version again, I would just lengthen this by about 2 inches. Do you prefer something to come in at the waist? That's your Mélilot. If you prefer something to skim you at the waist, that's your Kalle. I love them both, and that's why I bought the Mélilot after buying the Kalle. I think your Mélilot gives you more of a shirt-like option. So the strengths of the Kalle are really the quality of the instructions in the first place. I think they're good anyway, but then you've got the backup of the instructions on a blog post as well. I think each and every stage has got a good explanation within that blog post for the collar and the plackets and the burrito method and all that. I think the Kalle is a lot stronger on that. The Mélilot has got a little bit of support, but it's more to do with fitting. So it's grading and a small bust allowance, and then a few inspiration pictures and things like that. So I think it's a little bit weaker on the instructions. In fact, I think it's significantly weaker on the instructions. I hope you found this useful, and hope you've decided whether you're on Team Kalle or Team Mélilot, or if like me, you like both of them and you're going to buy both of them, or you've made both of them. Let me know below if which team you're on. Are you on Team Kalle or Team Mélilot? Have you bought one and been wondering whether you should buy the other one or not, and have tempted you to? I don't want to be enabling people, but I just wanted to point out the differences and the similarities, and help you make a decision whether you buy one or the other, or both. So I will insert some footage of me at the end wearing this one, where I've blended it together. I forgot to tell you, I'm calling it the Kallilot. So it's a Kalle and a Mélilot. So I've blended them both together, and I shall insert some footage at the end for you. So that's it from me. I shall speak to you later. Thanks for watching. Bye.